Cubs baseball on CSN Chicago is presented by State Farm. From Fenway Park in Boston, we're set for Cubs baseball tonight as the Cubs play their first interleague set here in 2017. Great to have you with us from the oldest ballpark in Major League Baseball. Jim Deshaies and Len Casper. We've got a lot of Cubs Red Sox connections. Anthony Rizzo was drafted by the Red Sox. He's had a wonderful road trip, and you know he's very excited about tonight.
A homecoming of sorts for Anthony, who was a sixth-round pick of the Red Sox back in 2007, was traded away as a minor leaguer to San Diego. So he never played for Boston, but deep roots with Anthony and this organization. And there's a deep fly ball off the bat of Anthony Rizzo, yet another home run. He's having a big road trip in that regard. Last six games, OPS up over 1,100. He's hit four home runs, driven in 12.
Cubs are 4-2 on this road trip. Red Sox have lost five of their last seven. They're not scoring a lot of runs, but they have some really good, young, exciting players.
Well, this weekend, fans are going to be treated to some of the best young players in all of baseball. You know all about the Cubs' young stars. Well, here's three making the grade, the killer bees, if you will, for Boston. Benintendi, he's just 22 years of age, high average hitter. Bogart, slick shortstop, can really swing the bat. Mookie Betts finished second in the American League in MVP voting. Last year, he's a potential 30-30 guy.
When we come back, we'll get you the starting pitchers, the DH in order. Kyle Schwarber will be that man for the Cubs, and I think you have an idea of who's going to pitch for the visitors. More coming up from Fenway.
Cubs baseball on CSN Chicago is brought to you in part by Lexus, who encourages you to experience amazing. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, through it all. Ford, who invites you to go further in their fuel-efficient vehicles. Check out our entire lineup at your local Ford store or buyfordnow.com. Menards, save big money at Menards. And Southwest Airlines, yes to low fares with nothing to hide. That's transparency.
In the first, Benny's Beverage Depot will donate $100 to the Greater Chicago Food Depository. Great to have you with us tonight. We have the first pitch coming up momentarily. Jake Arrieta, last time here at Fenway Park, almost threw his first no-hitter.
Yeah, dominant stuff from Arrieta. It was back in 2014, and it was just Jake Arrieta was starting to evolve as a pitcher. It was part of a six-start stretch in which he went 4-0 with an 0.89 ERA. Took a no-hitter into the sixth inning in his previous start against Cincinnati, and then was absolutely brilliant that night against Boston. Punched out 10, allowed just one walk, and then that lone single there after two men were out in the eighth inning.
Yeah, that was Stephen Drew. Notice David Ross was one of his strikeout victims. He would later throw two no-hitters, both on the road. And you know, these numbers really don't mean a whole lot because it's a different Jake Arrieta.
Yeah, most of that you're looking at was Arrieta before he became Jake Arrieta. The Baltimore Jake who struggled with his command, and that guy disappeared a couple of years ago. So 1-3 with a 486 for Jake against Boston. Drew Pomeranz will pitch for Boston here tonight. Cup saw him last year with the Padres, and he was really good at Wrigley. Six innings, did not allow any runs, struck out 10. He was an all-star last year with the Pods, then traded over here to the Boston Red Sox. He's not quite as good in a Red Sox uniform, but they are very high on the talented left-hander.
So he's had good numbers against the Cubs. It'll be the righty Arrieta for the Cubs, the left-hander Pomeranz for the Red Sox. 04, 07, 13. Red Sox winning the World Series. 2016, it was the Cubs' turn. David Ross right in the middle of both these last two World Series championships. We'll have Cubs baseball from Boston next.
From Teddy to Ernie, Rhino, and Big Poppy, tradition will be honored, both cursed in the past. But tonight, youth will be served. A possible preview of the Fall Classic on a spring night. Next.
Beautiful night for Cubs baseball here in Boston. Let's hear from Theo Epstein, Cubs president of baseball operations. He grew up just a couple of miles from Fenway Park, and he says it's great to be back home.
Went for a jog yesterday and was able to keep a really low profile, which is nice. But one guy who was jogging past me in the other direction just gave me a silent high five, which was good. It made me feel, you know, welcome back, which was this is a good feeling.
Did you
return
it?
City looks beautiful. I did, of course. And the city's looking beautiful today. It's really good to be home.
The cool part is coming back and seeing a lot of the friends and staff and all that stuff that worked here that you developed those relationships with over the years. And, you know, not just the on-field personnel, but the clubhouse guys and, you know, the parking lot guys. Like I said, the people that you see on an everyday basis that are kind of like family. So that's the fun part for me is seeing those guys and obviously catching up with the players.
Really neat. Now, John will not pitch in this series, but he did get to hand the home plate umpire Mike Ebert the lineup card tonight. And let's get the rest of the Cubs Southwest starting lineup. We mentioned Schwarber will be the DH in the leadoff spot. Chris Bryant batting second. Anthony Rizzo, the former Red Sox farmhand. Zobrist is familiar with this park. Addison Russell playing his first game here. Same goes for Contreras. Jason Hayward, really good numbers here at Fenway. Javier Baez at second, and Albert Almora Jr. batting ninth.
Take a look at the Red Sox defensively. All the B's in the outfield. Benintendi, the rookie in left. Jackie Bradley Jr. can really go get him. He's in center. Mookie Betts, tremendous defensively as well. He was the Gold Glove winner last year. He's the right fielder. Marco Hernandez, who was once a part of the Cubs organization, he plays third base. Bogarts and Pedroia up the middle. Mitch Moreland's the first sacker. Christian Vasquez is catching. Andrew Pomerantz, the 28-year-old left-hander, will toe the slab for the Bo Sox tonight. He's made three starts, 1-1 with a 4.60 ERA.
Mentioned Mike Everett. He's the crew chief and the plate umpire. Bill Welke at first, Bruce Dreckman at second, and big Jordan Baker over at third. A lot of Cubs blue in the stands.
Yeah, there was a buzz around town today. We're fired up for this early season matchup between these two clubs. And with strike one, they immediately go into the shift mode. Hernandez trots out into well over to the right side of second base, and Pedroia backs into shallow right.
Two strikes on Schwarber, 81 degrees as we get started. The Cubs are 12-9. One game lead over Milwaukee. In the National League Central, the Red Sox 11-10, 3.5 back of Baltimore, and in third place in the East, almost a month into the season. We are on both the main channel and Plus tonight. We'll be on CSN Plus. Actually, never mind. 1-2. And that's high.
Well, you expect to see a lot of high fastballs from Pomerantz tonight. That's a big part of his game. He's kind of an old school power pitcher with an elevated fastball and a real good curveball, a curveball that he leans on heavily. He threw it more than any other pitcher in baseball last year.
And Schwarber strikes out to start the ball game. Be nice these next couple of days and summer like. Looks like the highs though on Sunday will be in the low 50s, and that's an 8 o'clock start local time, so it'll be a chilly one for the game of the world Sunday night. Here's Chris Bryant. Comes in with an 8-game hitting streak, and he takes a strike.
There's that good curveball. So 39% of the time he threw his curveball last year, as I said, the highest curveball usage among pitchers who qualified. Had enough innings to qualify. I think Rich Hill actually threw his a little bit more.
There's a high deep drive, and it's gonna go over the monster. And you know, his father's the proudest man in the ballpark.
Yeah, I was just thinking about Mike Bryant. He's got to be going bananas right now. He, along with a good number of Cub fans here at Fenway, a point to dad, mom and dad, from Chris as he crosses home plate.
That was a shot.
Well, he was ready for that high fastball. Pretty good chance dad told him to look for it. That's your Ford home run replay. Cubs draw first blood. Bryant gets into that high heater. Hits it out onto Lansdowne Street.
So 1-0. Here's Anthony Rizzo, and he takes a curve for a strike. So Bryant with a 9-game hitting streak. His dad, Mike, is from Massachusetts. Played briefly in the Red Sox minor league system. Read Ted Williams' book. Actually, I talked to Teddy Ballgame about hitting, and he taught Chris everything he knows.
Yeah, Mike played his college ball just down the road here at UMass Lowell.
Oh, and 2 on Rizzo, who hugs the plate, particularly against lefties. He pops it up left field. It's Benintendi, and he makes the catch, two outs. comes Ben Zobrist. He's playing left with Schwarber DHing. This is only the third time the Cubs have played an interleague series here at Fenway. Wasn't a very good year for the Cubs in 2014, but they swept the Red Sox midseason. They lost 2 of 3 here in 2011. Two and oh on Zobrist.
Well, the Red Sox pitching has been really good. Talked about their lack of offense. That's been a big issue of late. There's a breakdown on the series history. Of course, these two teams met in the 1918 World Series, won by the Red Sox. They probably saw each other after the game and said, hey, this was fun. Let's do it again.
Tap foul. Yeah, they only had to wait 93 more years to meet up at Fenway, and it would be in the regular season.
Well, Theo Epstein, I'm sure, enjoying his time here in Boston this weekend. Couldn't fault him if he was standing in his seats or in a suite somewhere looking out, and I'm the master of all that I survey with these two clubs. Not his style.
Zobrist lines out to a sliding Mookie Betts. What a start to the series. Chris Bryant going over the monster. Cubs won. Red Sox coming up. We've got a long way to go. They have 11 home runs, fewest among all major league teams. Bogaerts, Benintendi, Betts at the top. The veteran guys in the middle, Ramirez, Moreland, Pedroia, batting sixth for the first time in his career. Bradley, Vasquez, and Hernandez to round it out.
Cubs are positioned where? Well, there's Ben Zobrist. He's out there in front of the big wall. Albert Almora Jr.'s got a lot of real estate to cover here. Center field at Fenway, Jason Hayward in right, third to first, Bryant Russell, Baez, Rizzo, Wilson Contreras is the behind catcher tonight, and our Lexus starting pitcher is Jake Arrieta. Lexus experience amazing, four starts into this season. He is 3-0 with a 3.65 earned run average.
With the Red Sox struggling to score runs, John Farrell, their manager, has Xander Bogaerts leading off. That's not the big story here. It's Dustin Pedroia hitting sixth. And first pitch inside on Bogaerts. All-star last year. And he waits on a 1-0. Inside again and maybe a little high. So Pedroia has now batted in all nine spots in the order.
Every time you see Pedroia, do you think of that movie, Oh Brother, Where Art Thou?
Ground ball back to the mound, and Arrieta will flip to Rizzo for the out.
He is straight up dirtbag, isn't he? And he loves to play the game.
Yeah.
Well, the Red Sox, high average hitting team. They're second in the American League in batting average, trailing just the Houston Astros, but no power at all. They've only hit 11 home runs all year.
Andrew Benintendi, the first round pick, 2015. Out of the University of Arkansas. So just his 55th major league game. He can rake. 5 for 5 in Baltimore on Sunday.
Got good hair too.
That he does. Curveball. It's 1-1.
Keep swinging it like this, they're going to put him on magazine covers here in Boston.
Check that 2-1. Bryant way off the line at third. Hit to deep right. Hayward back at the short wall, and he can't get it. It's a home run. That's his second.
No flirtation with a no-hitter tonight for Arrieta. Benintendi just got done talking about their lack of power. That's their 12th home run on the year. He's known as more of a line drive, sprayed around the field type guy who would likely pile up a bunch of doubles, but not so much the long ball. But he finds the Red Sox bullpen with this one.
Good effort by Hayward. Jason was watching the replay on the board. I think he thinks he should have caught it, but I don't know if he would have been able to get it without falling into the bullpen. Mookie Betts, 1-1. The runner-up to Mike Trout in the MVP balloting in the American League last year. Slider misses outside. Former Oriole fires low.
First couple of starts, there was concern about Arrieta's velocity. Last time out, that was not an issue. And ironically, he got hit around a little bit last time out by the Reds. Allowed 5 runs, 4 earned in 6 innings, but he didn't walk a man, and he struck out 8.
Shot out into left center. Almora can't keep Betts from a double.
Even without the little mishandle out there, Betts was intent on getting to second base on this ball, and had Albert got it cleanly, they might have had a shot at him. To go away with a fastball, and it drifts up and in a little bit. He's got a quick bat, he's strong, and he can run. Guy can do just about anything on a baseball field.
And he's bowled 7 perfect games as well. Other than that, he's just all right. Here's Hanley Ramirez.
Hey, we get to talk about bowling again.
You're all in on that
bowling roll here lately.
Called strike. one thing for the Red Sox these days is they're wistful about Big Poppy, who retired after quite a year last year. Ramirez has kind of moved all around the diamond over the course of his career. He started out as a shortstop. And that was with Boston. He got traded to Florida. He was a three-time All-Star with the Marlins. A little third base. The Dodgers to the outfield. The first and now to DH. That is a fair ball. Rizzo will try to run it down. Betts will score. And it's 2-1. Because of the quirky nature of this ballpark, that's probably the only park you'll see a first baseman go that far to retrieve a ground ball.
Yeah, it's what 305 to the pesky pole down the right field line, and then it jets out quickly. But you see where Hayward's position, and as softly as this ball is hit, Rizzo became the only guy who really was going to be able to track it down and prevent Ramirez from getting to second base.
So the Red Sox, who lost both games against the Yankees this week, scored one run combined. They've already topped that tonight. And that one gets past Contreras.
That outside corner just a little late to react as Arrieta pulls that fastball all the way across to the other side of the plate.
Swing and a miss by Mitch Moreland, 1-1. Gold Glover last year with Texas. Signed as a free agent in December.
And with Ortiz retiring, we could use Ramirez as the DH and plug in a good defender there at first base. And Moreland's pretty good hitter as well. He's got good power.
Recall the last time we were here, you caught a foul ball.
That's right.
We're in a pretty good spot. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is, gotta pay attention here.
Right on top of the action.
We'll get something tonight with a right-handed hitter off an elevated fastball from Pomerantz. Be ready to make a play. It was fun walking around here this morning, just tooling around a little bit, bumped into a bunch of Cub fans. One kid, he and his buddy, they drove 17 hours straight from Davenport, Iowa to come here. Apparently they were playing Go Cubs Go on the airplane flying in today.
There were members of the Cubs traveling party who stopped by the game last night, Yankees and Red Sox.
Well, the American League guys love to come to Wrigley and interleague play, and the National League guys love to come to Fenway. Even if the clubhouse is a little cramped.
Yeah, they did it right. Here in Boston and on the north side of Chicago over 100 years ago. 3-2 the count. Pedroia on deck. Early trouble for Arrieta.
Worthy of a conversation.
One rotation note, Brett Anderson originally was slated to start Sunday night. It'll be Kyle Hendricks instead. And Anderson will start the next homestand on Monday night against the Phillies. Three, two, base hit. Ramirez will score, and Moreland has a double. That's four consecutive Red Sox hits. It's 3-1.
Moreland had a good at bat. Got it looked like a bit of a hanging cutter. The head of Rizzo and into the corner goes. Always tricky for a right fielder here. If you try to cut that ball off and you don't, and it catches that little ring around, it'll be like a hockey puck in an arena. It could shoot way out towards right center. Speedy guy might circle the bases.
Acting pitching coach this weekend, Lester Strode. And Pedroia takes a strike. He got back in their lineup last night. Just three games with the left knee slash ankle injuries after the Manny Machado slide a week ago tonight. Gets by Contreras, and Moreland will move to third.
It's a point we make over and over and over again with starting pitchers. Sometimes you're just hoping to survive the first inning. You go out there, especially when you're on the road. Now you're not all that familiar with, especially when you get into interleague play. Kind of looking in at home plate, the backstop, it's a different look, a different feel. I was hoping to survive the first, get back in that dugout, regroup, and go from there.
Two wild pitches in the inning, infield in. Pedroia did what Chris Bryant has done. Rookie of the year and then MVP the following season. Three and one.
Four time Gold Glover. The interesting thing about Pedroia as a hitter, when he first came into the league, you know, he has a big hack. I mean, he lets it fly every time he decides to swing the bat, and everybody thought, well, that's just not going to play. He's going to strike out a bunch. Well, that has obviously not been the case.
And he walked him. So that will bring Lester Strode out to the mound before Jackie Bradley Jr. bats. Lester was saying fastball down and away, get a double play ball and get out of the inning. That's usually the prescription from a pitching coach,
yeah,
in this spot.
A little pep talk. And a lot of times it's like, what do you want to do? Well, you know, how do you want to start him? Fastball. Okay, give him a good heater down and away. Roll him over. See if we can get out of here.
Bradley, an all-star last year, recently on the DL, with a sprained knee, and he takes low for ball one. Recently turned 27. Corner man in, double play depth in the middle. Thirty pitches already for Jake here in the first.
First inning runs has been a bit of an issue for the Cubs pitchers this year.
Swing and a miss, 2-1. Here it is. Fastball, 2-2.
Trying to crowd him and a lot of run on that two seamer. Just Jake having a real hard time finding that consistent release point here in the first. Tell what they're trying to do with Contreras setting up inside. They're trying to throw that two seamer, kind of starts at the front hip and runs back to the corner. Previous one went middle away, and then this one he just, you know, and really fighting to get it in there, pulled it a little bit.
The 3-2 ground ball, base hit. Moreland scores. Pedroia to third, throw back to first late. It's 4-1, and we might see some action in the Cubs bullpen. Still only one out.
Yeah, you're just hoping, you know, he got his ground ball, and unfortunately for Arrieta, not in a spot where anybody can make a play on it. A lot of pace on that ground ball, too.
The number eight hitter, the catcher Christian Vasquez. Guys are stretching. No, nobody throwing yet in the bullpen. A strike. Vasquez debuted in 2014. Missed all of 2015 after Tommy John surgery. And another base hit. Pedroia scores. It's 5-1.
How about a mulligan? What a do-over. Vasquez shares the catching duties with Sandy Leon. He's a switch hitter. Vasquez, you know, nice swing of the bat. It's Red Sox club, I guess you could say, could argue they were due to break out. Last week, hitting just a touch over 200.
Marco Hernandez, who originally signed with the Cubs back in 09, traded to Boston December of 2014, and he takes a strike. Pablo Sandoval is on the disabled list.
That was a deal that the Cubs got pitcher Felix Dubront from the Sox.
Sandoval has a knee injury. And, just a few days ago went on the DL. over near the foul line. It is Zobrist to make the catch. That's the second out.
Like Wrigley, there's very little foul ground here. I would say less so here than any other ballpark in the major leagues. I mean, so hitters love this yard for a lot of reasons. Room to operate straightaway center field that will yield doubles and triples. And bang them off the wall and left, sneaking them around the corner and right. Would be outs drift into the stands and keep at bats alive.
Bogaerts grounded out to start this inning. Takes a curve for a strike. Pitch didn't get the call. And Bogaerts held on the swing.
Big old leg kick. Looks like he was able to check.
My guess is this might be a career high for pitches in the first inning by Jake Arrieta. 40. Here's 41. Two, he got him. Finally, out of the first, Red Sox get five and lead 5-1.
State Farm. Well, certainly some connections with these two franchises. Koji Uehara was a Red Sox from 2013 through 16. Did some great work. ALCS MVP in 2013. We talked about Anthony earlier, originally drafted by the Sox. Eric Hinsky, one of the Boston Colors for a couple of seasons, and the front office triumvirate of Epstein, Poyer, and McLeod, all with roots here. These championship teams that the Red Sox featured.
So they broke their big drought in 2004. The Cubs did it last year. A lot of work to do tonight, trailing early 5-1.
A lot of work, but a lot of time.
Russell in the right. He's gonna stay with a single.
Yeah, that's where having a center field speed in right field really pays off, the ability to hustle over and get to a ball like that, preventing Russell from getting into scoring position. And again, Addison doing a lot of work to right field in recent days, having a lot of success.
Now Wilson Contreras. And the pitch, it's a strike. Summer-like conditions. Maybe we'll see a big slugfest tonight. There have been a bunch of them over the years in this ballpark. Knocked down by Vasquez. Pomerantz was pretty highly touted. He was the fifth overall pick in the 2010 draft. Taken by the Indians out of Ole Miss. How about Bryce Harper, Jameson Taillon, Manny Machado, Christian Colon, and then Pomerantz, your top five picks that year.
What year was that? 10?
2010.
Yeah, then he was traded along to the Rockies, which you wouldn't wish that fate on any young pitcher. That phone call.
He was taken two picks ahead of Matt Harvey. And eight ahead of his now teammate Chris Sale, who's off to an unbelievable start.
Yeah, I watched some of that game on television last night. Sale Tanaka, a heck of a pitching matchup. A couple innings in, I thought Sale was going to throw no hitter. It was pretty nasty.
He's 1-2 with a 1.19. He's getting no run support. Ground ball right field. Two on, nobody out.
Come out and show your support of your world champion Chicago Cubs. The Cubs are back in town this Monday night for the start of a four-game set with the Fightin' Phils. Tickets are available for all four games. Get your tickets now at Cubs.com.
Chance to get back in the game here. First and second, nobody out. Jason Hayward, 10 out of 22. That's a .455 batting average. And two home runs in his career here at Fenway. A lot of that done with the Atlanta Braves.
Pomerantz will max out around 95 miles an hour with the fastball, but you won't see him there very often. He'll sit around 92. Mentioned a good curve. He also has a changeup. Doesn't use it all that much. Pitches like he did with San Diego last year. Sale continues to do what he's doing. They get David Price back healthy, pitching like David Price normally does. And
Porcello was a Cy Young award winner.
Yeah. Porcello looked good in his start the other night.
Two outside on a fastball.
Red Sox won the division last year after a couple down years. And then were swept by Cleveland in the division series. Here's David Price lurking behind Brian Butterfield, their third base coach.
Just wide again. John Farrell, former Major League pitcher. Fifth season as a Red Sox manager. He got him. Second strikeout for Pomerantz.
Spike curveball and well placed after a couple of heaters away. Goes back to the curveball. That one doesn't have a big hump in it. That's a tough pitch to recognize. Very sharp breaker.
Baez batting eighth. Normally where you see the Cubs pitcher. That's in National League games. Playing under American League rules this weekend. Russell at second. Contreras at first, one out, second inning. Red Sox knock Jake Arrieta around. Five in the first after Chris Bryant hit one over the monster.
Well, always a challenge for right handed hitters, especially young hitters who don't have a lot of experience in this ballpark, to come in here and not try to get hook happy trying to pull the ball over the wall. The pitch that Javi is most vulnerable to is the right handed slider out of the zone, and Pomerantz, being a left hander, doesn't have one of those. So maybe he can do some damage here tonight.
A couple of hits on Wednesday in Pittsburgh. And the pitch.
Ooh. Guessing he was sitting off speed there.
Well, if you are of the belief that you get one really good pitch to hit every at bat, that may have been the one.
Well, the challenge is not to then, you know, once strike one comes, a lot of guys chase. If you're patient and you can work the count, you might get that second cookie. You ask real nice.
Mora on deck.
It's nice to have the guy with Baez power down at the bottom of the order, though.
Play ball. And the Cubs cannot take advantage of the two hits to start the inning. 5-1, Red Sox early. video highlights of John Lester, John Lackey, and Koji Uehara, World Series champions with the Red Sox.
And each being recognized, tipping their hat from the Cubs dugout.
Will pitch tomorrow afternoon against knuckleballer Stephen Wright. And a strike called. Benintendi.
Koji recognizing the crowd.
Swing and a miss on a changeup. 0-2.
Yeah, this is where you got to be mentally tough. You got to turn the page. You wait 5 days to make that start. You get ambushed in the first inning. I feel like you've been kicked in the teeth, but you got to keep competing. Here from 2010 to 14, Lester with that long run, 110 game winner.
Which one's Big John? Are they both Big John?
Yeah,
this one's
Big
a left-handed
John.
Version. Hopped up by Betts. Shortstop calling for it. Russell has it for the out.
In the pregame interview, media scrum, John Lester was asked about the difference between, or was there a difference between Boston and Chicago? And he just started to chuckle. He's like, kidding me? He found things a little more intense here than he finds them in the Midwest. I think a lot of it, too, is, you know, here as a younger player, when you're first exposed to it, it's a little different.
By the way, the 42 pitches in the first inning for Arrieta, the most he's ever thrown in an inning, not just the first. The 1 ground ball to Baez, so Arrieta needed a quick second. He gets it. We're in Boston for the weekend. The Cubs trail 5-1 after 2.
He faces his old team along with his mates in the Chicago Fire. Coverage starts at 6 on CSN with Chicago Fire pregame. They'll be on the pitch.
Gorgeous night in Boston. Cubs got a first inning home run from Chris Bryant, but then the Red Sox responded with 5 big ones against Jake Arrieta. So third inning.
Opportunity in the third with first and second, nobody out, couldn't cash in. But boy, they had a bunch of that in Pittsburgh the other night too.
Yep. A lot of chances. 0-1 on Almora. And he drives one deep to left, back toward the wall. Gone, a home run. Number 2 for Albert, 5-2.
It's an easy game. Stride up there to home plate, hit it over the wall, run around the bases. And again, it's the elevated fastball. That's what Bryant hit. There's your Ford home run replay. These Cub hitters gearing up from the high cheese from Pomerantz. Bryant got him, and now Almora delivers.
Strike on Schwarber. And now the third baseman Hernandez, like he did in the first, will head over to the other side of the field.
See, there have been a number of left-handed pitchers that have had a lot of success in this ballpark over the years. Like John Tudor comes to mind. Tudor was a sinker changeup guy, so those right-handed hitters would try to pull him, and he'd just get him rolling over on that sinking soft stuff. Pomerantz, his game is different. He throws the high heater.
Two pitch called strike 3.
Could have been low. Vasquez did a nice job presenting it to Mike Everett, the home plate umpire.
Bryant, 1-for-1 with a home run. Takes outside.
More discerning with that first pitch fastball, a little two-seamer off the corner. What are you looking for here, Chris? You gonna spin it?
To right, and foul.
That would have been fun to curl one around the pole.
It's the Pesky pole in right.
Yeah, named after Johnny Pesky, a little scrappy guy who hardly ever hit any home runs, but every now and then he'd sneak one down there. So, yeah, that would be the Fenway bucket list, right? And go over the wall for one and around the pole for another one.
Two and one.
Red Sox have the shift down for Bryant. Look for how far off the bag Moreland is. With Bryant's speed, that could be a challenge on a ground ball to the left side. Moreland's really going to have to get after it to get in position to receive a throw.
And he went. 2-2. By the way, the Green Monster was constructed in 1934. It was not named that until much later. and it wasn't actually green until 1947. 40s and 50s. It was called the fence or the Fenway fence. Ground ball to Pedroia on the shortstop side.
Check out the variety of luxury premier options that Wrigley Field has to offer for your next client, corporate, or family function, like an all-inclusive suite experience located on the Nuveen Suite level. Visit Cubs.com/premier for an option that fits your needs. Jeff Garland's favorite place to hang out when he comes to the ballpark.
Rizzo flied to left. His first time up. Huge road trip. First six games, four homers, 12 knocked in, and a towering fly that will be called in by Betts midway in the third. 5-2 Red Sox.
Summer Fun Spots opens on May 5th, and their Kentucky Derby party is May 6th. Tickets are currently on sale for the Arlington Million with a special online discount. Visit arlingtonpark.com. Arlington, bet on fun.
Well, that young Cub fan having fun, even though his team trails. Hey. Well, wait a minute.
Turncoat.
Bottom three. Outside, ball one. Mitch Moreland. RBI double and a run as the Red Sox at 10 come to the plate in the first. The blue against the red tonight.
Yeah, I was going to mention that earlier. My own little grievance with this thing.
I know you're going.
These two old-timey franchises, we need to be white and gray here tonight.
Called strike.
Yeah, this would be a good weekend to have a throwback game too, just where old time unis.
Maybe from 1918?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, they did that a few years ago. The Cubs were here.
Probably why I thought of it.
Right.
I saw it before.
Yeah. Back to the mound. Six in a row now retired by Arrieta.
Finishes in good fielding position with reflexes. A very efficient second inning for Jake. And what's Boz call him? Hines innings, because you have to catch up when you've exhausted or use that many pitches in an inning. You've got to try to get back more into that 15 pitch per inning program.
1-0 on Pedroia is a strike. Bit inside, maybe high. Jake wanted it. Here's his 2-1. 2-2. Yankees back home and trailing the Orioles 4-0 in the fourth inning. Yanks will come to Wrigley Field next weekend. That'll be fun. The return of Starlin Castro to the north side. Pedroia strikes out.
The Cubs are out of town Mother's Day weekend, but you can still treat mom at the park at Wrigley on Saturday, May 13th with a ticket to Craft and Cuisine. Craft and Cuisine is a culinary and craft beverage event featuring more than 40 beer and wine tastings, live music, and chef demonstrations, food samplings from some of Chicago's most celebrated chefs. Purchase your tickets today at parkatwrigley.com. There'll be all kinds of fun events going on at the park at Wrigley. Throughout the baseball season and beyond.
Strike to Bradley. RBI hit in the first. Swing and a miss. So at Wrigley, you got to look at the old board in center and do the math on the score. Here, you got to look to the monster for that line score. Bounced foul to first. As old school as it gets.
There used to be a berm out there in front of the wall years ago.
And Arrieta in his second consecutive scoreless inning. And he trails 5-2 after three. season long. Friday, May 5th, Budweiser will provide Cubs T-shirts to up to the first 5,000 early arriving fans 21 and older in the Budweiser bleachers. Get there early. For details, visit Cubs.com/Fridays. Long weekend in Boston, off day yesterday. Night game tonight, late afternoon tomorrow, night game Sunday. Zobrist to start the fourth, robbed of a hit by sliding Mookie Betts. His first time up. And just the other kind of quirks of this park that are pretty easily noticed when you walk in. The dugouts are kind of pushed well up the foul lines, and they line up with the actual bases. So if you compare that to Wrigley, looks like it's a good 50 feet out toward the outfield. Mm-hmm. Comparatively. You mentioned the very tiny visitors clubhouse here, and it is small. Zobrist in the air to left. Benintendi on the warning track with the catch and the out. Two good swings, but he's 0 for 2.
Yeah, the bullpens, those were added 40s maybe in front of the outfield seats, and they've referred to that as Williamsburg. It was Ted Williams could hit more home runs.
Russell 1 for 1. Came in and hitting 320 on the trip. The first two games ever here were rained out. So the actual opener in 1912 was played on April 20th. That same day, Navin Field in Detroit opened, later renamed Briggs Stadium and then Tiger Stadium, as Russell will reach. And he's going to head to second as the ball goes out of play. So it'll be a single and an error. And he's 2 for 2.
Poked a base hit to right last time. Now it's just a little slow roller. It turns into a knock for him. And the Red Sox catch a break here, because if this ball stays in play, he likely makes third base.
So a couple of shots now to get him in. Fenway opened 5 days before the Titanic met its demise.
But not Molly Brown. She was unsinkable.
Series here, their first year in business at Fenway. The old NL Braves played here a few years as well.
These guys, I don't think, like the location of that one. Wants to confer with his pitcher.
Boston Braves played here 1914 and 15. 1-1 the count. Here it is. It's low. That's all you. You had an interesting idea of this road trip and the Cubs opponents.
Well, the Cubs have been around since 1876. So the Cubs, Reds and Pirates have all been in business since the late 1800s. And the Red Sox started playing in 1901. So collectively, yeah, the Cubs plus their three opponents on this trip have played a lot of baseball games. We're talking about the original six in hockey.
2-2.
The four franchises combined have played over 80,000 major league games.
In on the hands and a little soft liner caught by Pedroia, two gone.
I'm not counting them, but it seems to me like Pomerantz is using his curveball a little bit less tonight than he normally does.
You say almost 40%, right?
Yeah.
Russell at second. Two outs. Cubs trail by three. Both runs coming on home runs over the monster. Bryant in the first. Almora in the third.
Two. Well, it looked to be a very good pitching matchup in Washington tonight. Has turned out to be a hitter's night so far. Scherzer for the Nationals, DeGrom for the Mets. And the Mets have a 5-3 lead in the fourth. Scherzer's been touched up for 8 hits and 5 runs and 4 innings of work. They've each given up a couple of home runs. Ooh, they're going to run out of timeouts here.
Yeah, how about that at Colorado? Trey Turner hit for the cycle as part of his big series.
Yeah, and, you know, Harper's off to a great start. Ryan Zimmerman went deep again tonight. That team appears to be loaded.
Hayward strikes out and we go to the bottom of the fourth. Still Boston 5 and the Cubs 2.
you'll get a full recap of the picks and what to look forward to in the upcoming season. In the Loop Prime Bears recap Sunday at 10:30. After a rocky first, Jake has settled in. The question is it too little too late? As the Cubs try to come back against Pomerantz in what has been a very good Boston Red Sox bullpen to this point in the season. Catcher Vasquez to lead it off. 8-9-1 for Boston here in the home fourth.
Good start. Kick and the pitch. One and one.
Certainly could have been.
Well, they say sometimes about good starting pitchers, you better get to them early. You won't get to them at all. And fortunately for Arrieta, the Red Sox did get to him early.
Yeah, because, you know, sometimes you're having a hard time locating. You're just trying to get the feel of your breaking pitch out there early in the ball game, first inning in particular. Sometimes you just need a little luck. Somebody hit one on the button right at somebody. They turn it into a double play. And, you know, you get out of there allowing just a couple of runs instead of the five spot that he gave up. Boxing, you can be saved by the bell, but in baseball, you got to get all three outs.
Baez totally fooled by that ground ball. I don't know if he was anticipating it would go up the middle or what, but.
Yeah, I don't know if he was shifting just prior to the pitch and wasn't able to get turned around and go the other way. If he didn't see, the pointing at his eyes as if he didn't see it off the bat very well. Yeah, it was just a bad read. That problem earlier this year. Where were we in the signage behind home plate?
Was it St. Louis?
Yeah, that sounds right.
First series of the year. Ground ball, base hit. So 8 and 9 with hits to start the inning.
Great effort by Russell, but again, this ground ball's got a little pace on it. No play made. So a couple ground balls induce, but first and second, nobody out, and the lineup turns over.
So here's Bogaerts, who made two of the three outs in the first.
The DNA of those Red Sox championship teams from years ago were, you know, patient, grind out at bats. You think of Euclid and that group. This team, not so much. They don't strike out much. They're among the best in baseball in that regard. But I don't think they're as patient a group as those earlier teams.
Curveball got away. Evan Euclid is in the ballpark tonight. He now works for the Cubs.
Pedro Martinez is in the house. They had a shot of Louis Tion up on the big board. He's here. Ryan Dempster threw out the first pitch. But a little around the horn double play.
Orioles now lead 5-1 at New York. They're in the fifth. Manny Machado homering over Monument Park, estimated distance 470 feet. Longest home run of the year. 2-1. Now 3-1. It's Benintendi on deck. Nobody out. More trouble for Jake. And that'll get somebody up in the Cubs bullpen.
Scurrying.
Tander Mike Montgomery. Bryant will play even with a bag at third. Everybody else back. Wide for ball one.
Montgomery home run strikeout tonight. He really doesn't do either of those very often.
You call that a strike? 0-1.
From the changeup.
That is in jeopardy tonight.
You're Jake Arrieta, you start this at bat thinking, well, I get a ground ball double play, that would be great. Once you get the jump on him, you're thinking, let's punch this guy out and then get our double play. Get out of here unscathed.
And he has a sign. And a 1-2. Tap foul. And a 10-day homered into the bullpen in the first. Red Sox club came in with the fewest homers in the majors. Called strike three. That's the first out and a big one.
Two seam, come on back fastball. I think the earlier changeups in the sequence set that up.
Down by Contreras.
Folks around here last year thought Mookie Betts should have been the most valuable player in the American League. Yet 214 hits, most ever by a right-handed batter for the Red Sox.
Middle infielder early in his minor league career. Mentioned he's a great bowler. Thank you. his high school bowling average was 240. But his final 2 years in high school, he also batted over 500 on the baseball team. So
it's a rare combination when you talk about two sport athletes.
Yeah. One, one, now one and two. You know, some nights you'd rather have a guy make contact here and hit a ground ball, but the way it's gone for Jake tonight, he might rather miss a bat.
Yeah, you just get a little, you get a little wary, you get a little gun shy when contact has found so many holes. You just have to make a pitch, execute a pitch, turn it loose, and as pitchers will tell you, once it's out of your hand, it's out of your control. Always shooting for either soft contact or a swing and a miss.
Two, two. Caught by Bryant. Out at third. Double play. That'll work.
Yeah, that's not the double play they had in mind, but it'll work. And John Farrell asking for a little time to contemplate a challenge here. I don't know.
Well, it looked like Vasquez beat him, but his hand didn't quite get there. I think he's out.
I think he's out too.
Yep. And no challenge. Remember that inning if the Cubs come back tonight. Still 5-2.
Infinity. Well, you just saw it. Chris Bryant homered earlier. This time he snares the line drive, sprints to the back, knew exactly what he wanted to do. No hesitation, and it paid off as he beat Vasquez to the base by a nanosecond. That's your Giga Time moment right there.
So fifth inning. Baez will lead it off. In a battle for Jake tonight.
Javi, as he came up to hit it, was talking with Vasquez and pointing to the backstop again as if to say that the signage got him on that ground ball that he misread. So that'd be something MLB is going to have to address.
First pitch strike.
I'm sure there are rules. I know there are rules about what can be back there, but might have to take a second look.
It was an MLB sign in St. Louis. It had a white background. But, after the fact, said We won't use that rotating sign behind home plate. Also could have been just from Baez's angle at second and not being familiar with this park, maybe just someone with a white shirt behind home plate as that ball got into the hitting zone. Might not be a sign at all. One and two. And he got him. Strikeout number five for Pomerantz.
Yeah, breaking ball down in the dirt. He's going through a real tough stretch right now.
Now Mora with a home run in the third. And he looks at a strike. Late swing and a bouncer to Pedroia. Easy play. Two outs. Schwarber, who has struck out both times. Now, one of the cardinal rules of being a big league broadcaster is you're never supposed to admit when you're feeling less than 100%. But in this era of Twitter, I've gotten a ton of tweets. You doing okay? Yeah, I feel fine. Just battling a head cold, and so I'm a little stuffed up. So. Thank you for your wishes. Was it the Fernando line, Billy Crystal from Saturday Night Live? It's better to look good than to feel good. I guess it's better to sound good than to feel good in our business, but I feel better than I sound.
You look marvelous, guy, Fernando.
Look, yes. Remember, darling, it's better to look good than to feel good. How about that for Schwarber? That was almost like a bunt. In the left.
Yeah, basically a block. Like he was playing cricket and defending the wicket, and he's a little shrug as he looks into the dugout and says, I'll take it. He punched out first two times up. A little redirect. It's like dead ball era baseball there.
Well, after you've struck out twice, not a bad idea. Put a ball in play. Here's Bryant. Cubs now one big swing away from getting right back into this game. By Vasquez.
Yeah, Pomerantz fully aware of that. A little defensive here in his approach to Bryant. Vasquez has an outstanding reputation for his defensive work.
Three and nothing.
You might hook him right here. You might throw him a curveball on 3-0. On the bottom of his own.
Yep. That's kind of like a throwaway line in a broadcast. 3-1, Schwarber at first, and he throws over.
Yeah.
That's like repeating the score with nothing else to say. Here it is, and he walked him. Tying run will come to the plate.
Well, I think it was he just didn't want to make that 3-1 pitch to Bryant. And, you know, he knew sooner or later he was going to have to make it. But he figured, I'll buy a little time, throw to first, and give me a little more time to think about it, decide what I want to do.
Means a lot to Anthony to be here in Boston, even though he never got to the big leagues with the Red Sox. Nice piece on that Cubs.com by Kerry Muscat about Rizzo being so thankful to the Red Sox, who helped him through his cancer treatments in 2008. And remember, John Lester helped him out as well at that time, having previously battled cancer. Pitch. On a hop to Pedroia, and that'll end the threat. Cubs strand two and trail 5-2.
You can follow Patrick Mooney, our Cubs insider, at csnchicago.com, presented by nationwide agent Jeff Vukovich. Go to jeffvuk.com or follow him on social media. Nationwide is on your side.
The World Series trophy will be here this weekend. So they'll have the Red Sox 04 trophy and the Cubs 16 trophy. The Curse Breakers. Pretty cool. Hanley Ramirez takes a strike.
Yeah, that'll be a great photo op for the fans.
And some big charity events this weekend, both here in Boston and back home in Chicago. The 0-1. Fouled at the plate. Tomorrow morning, the 12th annual, I can't believe it's been 12 years already, Race to Wrigley Charity Run. It's a 5K route. And it's an updated course. You will be running through historic Wrigley Field. And it begins promptly at 8 a.m. Central Time. They're expecting to raise over $475,000 for Cubs charities. Highest total to date. Tomorrow night here in Boston at the famous Paradise Rock Club, we'll have Hot Stove Cool Music featuring Eddie Vedder. And I am told, JD, before they even open the doors tomorrow night, they have already raised over $750,000.
Wow. Good work.
Red Sox have teamed up with Theo Epstein's foundation to be named later. Cubs and Sox will raise a ton of money for children's charities. Can't wait. That's the other thing about winning a World Series is it creates even more interest in your ball club, and a lot of Cubs players have charitable foundations. That one's going to bang off the monster. Zobrist will field it. And it's a single for Ramirez.
That had no chance to be anything but a single. As quickly as that ball got out there, Zobrist didn't overplay it. It looks like a changeup. Floated up there, belt high for Hanley Ramirez.
Here's Moreland. Yeah, when you create more interest in your ball club, your ability to raise money for good causes also increases. Swing and a miss. Ramirez running, and he is out at second.
Red Sox taking a look at this as well. It looked like he's going to beat it. Got a pretty good jump here. Contreras just drifts down to his knee, snaps off that throw, and Russell applying the quick tag. Get a good look at it here. Ooh. No challenge.
Well, the Red Sox runners here in these last couple of innings appearing to get to the base before the fielder, but kind of getting caught in the dirt, not getting that hand or foot to the bag in time. Two and one. Montgomery up yet again. Way outside. Moreland's double in the first inning. It was his major league leading 12th already. Masahiro Tanaka, JD mentioned it earlier, he went the distance last night. He threw 97 pitches against this Red Sox team. Arrieta nearing that.
Adam Maddox, didn't they? Complete game shutout, less than 100 pitches.
Four.
Left-handed hitting Jackie Bradley Jr. on deck, so this might be it for Jake here.
foul.
Be really big to play this game at a high level. Pedroia, a great example of that. This whole Red Sox team, their whole outfield is about 5'10".
Yeah, we did a bit on the average height and the various defensive positions around the diamond. Mookie Betts, under 6 feet tall, as a right fielder. Base hit to center for Pedroia.
Imagine that's going to be it for Jake. Montgomery has plenty of time. He's hot and ready to go, and here comes Joe.
So first time in 73 starts, Jake Arrieta will not be able to complete 5 innings. Pitching change in the fifth, and we'll be right back. And seasonings call to the pen, call grilling flavor up to the big leagues. Here's Mike Montgomery.
Mike worked scoreless inning Wednesday in Pittsburgh. For the season, he has pitched 8 times, 2.13 ERA. Obviously, a critical juncture in this game with a couple of men on base, down 3 already. Pensive Jake Arrieta. Bradley Jr., a 244 lifetime hitter against left-handed pitching.
Two on, one out. All of Boston's runs to this point came in the first inning. That's a strike.
Uncle Charlie.
Swing and a miss. is, and the tap's foul. And the count holds. Mike, 6'5", 215. Third major league season. Bounce softly, Baez will touch second, double play. 4-3 to get out of the inning. So after five from Fenway Park, it's 5-2 Boston.
Championship season, Fly the W book, which features personal essays by Tom Ricketts, Theo Epstein, and others, as well as never before seen photos. For more information, visit cubs.com/flythewbook.
Well, Drew Pomerantz has given up a couple of home runs, but he's got a 5-2 lead as he faces the middle of the Cubs order here in the sixth. Zobrist has lined out twice.
He's been able to pitch around some traffic. Got a double play ball back in the second. He has not yet had a 1-2-3 inning this evening.
It was a rare changeup, I believe, from Pomerantz. Curve, strike.
Benz hit it hard twice tonight, but no luck yet.
Well, if he's in the lineup tomorrow, might he hit right-handed against the knuckleballer? He said he's done it both ways and did not really give a definitive answer as to which side is more comfortable. He made it sound like both sides are uncomfortable against guys like Stephen Wright and R.A. Dickey. 3-2.
Yeah, you know, the knuckleball, obviously a very slow pitch with the erratic movement, and the reason why a switch hitter might hit right-handed, even though Wright's a right-handed pitcher, just gonna see if I can get the word right into this statement more frequently, is you kind of you're forced to keep your front side in longer. I think as a left-handed hitter, you see the ball out of his hand and you get a little jumpy and there's a tendency to pull off.
Leadoff walk. John Lackey will pitch for the Cubs.
The Some switch hitters have done that in the past too against guys with real good changeups. Been a tough go for Wright so far though. That 866 ERA and a opponent batting average of 413. Knuckler must not be knuckling very well.
Well, they had a knuckleballer here for a long time, Tim Wakefield. Russell, strike one. Two for two tonight. Average up to 291.
Had a bunch of multi-hit games last 10 days or so. Probably got at least one long one in him this weekend. Should be as good a time as any, but he's down in the count 0-2.
Zobrist back. Pitch 2-2. Pomerantz has not gone more than six in any of his starts to begin the year.
Yeah, you know, he's the type of pitcher that typically would run high pitch counts. Elevated fastballs get fouled back a lot. The curveballs are swing and miss pitch. You know, he's not throwing sinkers up there pitching to contact. Last year, opposing batters hit just 217 against Pomerantz. He's the ninth best mark in Major League Baseball. More of a fly ball type pitcher, so can be hurt by the long ball from time to time. Cubs have got him twice tonight.
He got him.
And he made a pitch. That front arm up high, create some deception, and then bust that fastball right over the plate at the knees.
I mentioned the batting average against. Jake Arrieta last year was number one. Opponents hit 194 against him, so these two guys were pretty stingy in giving up hits. 16 combined so far tonight. Contreras, one for two. Joe Maddon, long time American League manager, and before that, on the coaching staff of the Angels. And he was tactful but forceful, I thought, today. Said, I like the NL game better. Bounce to Moreland, a bobble, and he won't get anybody.
Got a little greedy, perhaps, trying to be too quick, thinking he might be able to get two outs. Instead, he'll get none.
So an error on the Gold Glove first baseman. Oh, they're going to give him a hit? Wow, okay, take it. Now they're saying E3. Okay. That's the right call.
Mm-hmm.
Pitching line of the night goes to Adam Conley of the Marlins. An inning and two thirds. Five hits, nine runs, all earned.
Ooh. More traffic for the Cubs. Two on, one out. 0-4-5 with runners in scoring position.
Pomerantz has had Hayward's number tonight. He struck him out both times swinging.
No hits in the inning. A walk to Zobrist. A one out error. Allowing Contreras to reach. One and two. Former Cardinal Joe Kelly. Up in the Boston bullpen. Try it again. Still one and two.
Red Sox operating with a six-man bullpen. Kit Barnes is serving suspension for throwing behind the head of Manny Machado the other day.
Two to Hayward is outside and low. Two and two. Strikes out. Got him on the swing. Number seven for the lefty. So it's Baez. He has hit into a double play and struck out swinging. Zobrist at second. Contreras at first. And the pitch in there for a strike.
The way it goes, right, when a hitter's scuffling and striking out a bunch, steps up to the plate telling himself, I'm going to be patient. That flips a little get over curveball in there, and all of a sudden you're down 0-1. Can you maintain that discipline? Don't let that one pitch influence the whole at bat.
Bounce to third. Loved by Hernandez, and the Cubs strand two. They've left six on. It's 5-2.
Sons Fine Jewelers. See 500 Tacori engagement rings and receive a gift card equal to your sales tax this weekend at James and Sons in Chicago.
Five, two. Big first for the Red Sox. They got all five off the starter Arrieta.
I don't know if it remains the case, but years ago I remember reading that 5-2 was the average score of every baseball game ever played.
Really? Interesting.
Yeah, the winning team averaged 5 and the losing team averaged 2.
Vasquez from the 8th spot has 2 hits and an RBI. 26. He's from Puerto Rico. 9th round pick, 2008. Got away from Mike.
What else is happening on a Friday night? The Cardinals lead Cincinnati 3-1, bottom of the fourth in St. Louis.
They swept a doubleheader yesterday over the Blue Jays. And that got them back to 500.
Mm-hmm. Pittsburgh thumping the Marlins.
The ground to Russell. Jason Mott is back in the major leagues with Atlanta, and he shaved his beard.
Any particular reason?
He said his daughter shaved it. She was excited to do it, and then after she did it, she said, quote, "You look weird, put it back on." Pedro Strop.
Those hard hitting Brewers and the Braves are tied 4-4 in the fourth. No No home run for Thames. He's back in the lineup. He missed one game with a little hammy issue. Arcia has homered his third. It's Anderson and Colon pitching in that ball game.
Montgomery to Hernandez, and off the end of the bat was perfectly placed for his second hit tonight.
A ground ball, a single up the middle first time, now a little flare off the end of the bat, fooled by the curveball. It's a good pitch. Montgomery's had real good action on that breaking ball tonight. Off the end of the bat, just doinks it into shallow center.
Bogarts without a hit, but he walked in the fourth.
There's a little statistical oddity for you, and I doubt that it'll remain this way for very long. The top five team ERAs in Major League Baseball are all American League clubs.
Wow. Red Sox are one of them, right?
Yeah. Yankees, White Sox, Baltimore, Boston, Houston. Houston and the Dodgers are actually tied. Coming into play tonight. John Farrell, the manager, and his fine pitching coach, Carl Big Train Willis. They're together in Cleveland.
The inside corner. One ball, one strike. Bogarts came up in 2013, just a handful of games, and then he took over the postseason at third base, replacing Will Middlebrooks. And he smacks that one into center.
Charlie Browned him. Talked about missed opportunities for the Cubs, the Red Sox as well. A lot of traffic since that first inning, but have not been able to pad their lead.
The 0-1 bounces. You mentioned the other day, you would expect to see an increase in DL stints because the 15-day DL is now the 10-day DL, and that is absolutely happening. About a 12% increase to this point.
Yeah, it used to be if a guy had a little bit of a nagging injury, clubs would wait because they didn't want to lose him for the full 15 days, and they would wait, and then finally either he'd be able to return to action or they'd backdate him and then you'd have to make a transaction. Now, given that it's only 10 days, I think they're more willing to, okay, let's just shut you down, get somebody else up here.
Baez, Russell, double play. That'll take us to the seventh. Still a 5-2 ball game.
We're in Boston. We're at Fenway. And the Cubs trail by three. The Cubs offer baseball summer camp presented by ATI Physical Therapy and Ideal Industries. Young sluggers ages 5 to 13 have the chance to suit up in Cubs gear, meet a current Cub player during a VIP Wrigley Field visit, and receive top-notch baseball instruction. Enroll now at any of the 8 Chicagoland locations. Visit Cubs.com/kids for more information. This is left-hander Robbie Scott. Robbie Scott is pitching for the 8th time, and he has an ERA of 0. Lefty specialist. You see he's only worked 4 innings.
Non-drafted free agent.
Finesse style. 86-87 with the heater. Slider, curve, and change. And Robbie Ross, too, they just sent him out.
Well, if you send out one Robbie, you got to have another in reserve. Al Mora. 1-for-2 with a home run. Scott, a Miami, Florida native. That's where Albert's from.
Had a cup of coffee with the Red Sox last year, appeared in 7 games. Triple A Pawtucket is where he spent most of the year. 4-3 with a 2.54 ERA there. He made 6 starts and 26 relief appearances.
Red Sox closer is Craig Kimbrel. Full count. Top of the order coming up. Schwarber, then Bryant. Both these bullpens have pitched well here in the early going.
They've got a righty up in the Red Sox bullpen.
He walked him.
John Farrell wants to be ready to react. I mean, what happens with Schwarber here? He's got a right-hander ready for Bryant. Joe Kelly, he was up earlier.
I like that glove.
Joe Kelly sounds like he should be walking the beat here in Boston. Or running a tavern or something.
Lefty, lefty. Scott to Schwarber, and it's low.
Drop down. Walk plays just fine here. Down 3, Brian on deck.
Major league appearance. Cubs trying to get that record for the first time as Scott has yet to give up a run as a big leaguer. Schwarber tried to bunt. I was just going to ask you if he would think about it against a lefty with nobody playing third base.
Yeah, and what they do is they play him honest until he has a strike, and then they shift. So on the 1-1 with the drop down lefty out there, I think that's what influenced his decision to try that. And the good idea just didn't execute it.
Outside, I suppose one advantage or disadvantage, depending on your point of view, of the dugout placement here at Fenway is if Joe Maddon wants to yell at Mike Everett, it's a little more difficult for Everett to hear him. Swing and a miss, strike three.
Lose your voice by the end of the night trying to scream at the home plate umpire.
Maybe that's my excuse. That's tough. Here comes John Farrell. He's going to go with a right-hander. Seventh inning, 5-2. One on, one out. Here's Joe Kelly. With a man on and one out, and his team leading by three in the seventh.
Former starting pitcher has made the move to the bullpen, having success with a 150 ERA this year through eight appearances. According to the website Fangraphs, he is the fourth hardest thrower in Major League Baseball, averaging just under 99 miles per hour with his heater. Aroldis Chapman, Trevor Rosenthal, Ariel Hernandez, and Joe Kelly. Always had a good arm, but I don't remember seeing 99 out of Joe in the past. And even with that good heater, he really mixes it up, throws the slider and curveball a good bit.
Bryant has homered, grounded out, and walked. -99 and a strike.
Of course, when we saw Kelly with the Cardinals, he was starting, and it's fairly typical for a guy who makes the move from the rotation to the bullpen to add a little velocity. We're in air it out mode. triple digits on that one.
Almora, the runner at first. Long pause by Kelly. The pitch, 101, but too high. A slider low and away, 3-2. The times the Cubs have scored, a couple of home runs over the Green Monster. Bryant in the first, Almora in the third. That's been it. And now Bryant's at the plate, Almora's on base.
Kelly actually spent a good chunk of time down at Triple A Pawtucket last year. He's upticking his velocity each of the last three or four seasons. Just gets a little bit quicker each successive year.
Bryant went. Mike Everett made the call.
And they called it on the swing. Bryant complaining, Madden shaking his head as if to say, why don't we at least check a feel with the base umpire. I'm not convinced.
Rizzo takes ball one. Hitting for average on this trip, but he is hitting for power, driving in a lot of runs. Six out of 28, low 200s on the trip, but four homers and 12 RBIs. Not even seven games.
102.
Yeah, maybe he went down to AAA to learn how to throw harder. This is crazy. Great job just to get a piece of that pitch.
Yeah, you got to be so quick. Elevated 100. Yeah. I was talking to a scout years ago talking about Billy Wagner, and he said, I got to turn in reports that this kid throws 100 miles an hour plus he's sneaky, and I'm not so sure there isn't a little of that going on with Kelly, too. That's a pretty short, quick little arm stroke he's got. It looks like he hides the ball pretty well.
That will get it to right. Almora will head to third.
Work by Rizzo to fight off that previous high fastball. Staying the at bat, he gets a slider down and in a little bit. Finds a little operating room on the right side to deliver the base hit. Well, here we go again, another opportunity to at least get a little bit closer. Zobrist has a good plate appearances tonight, 0 for 2, but he hit the ball hard both times and then worked the walk in the sixth.
Gets away. Almora makes it 5-3.
That breaking ball, when it hits the dirt, is going to kick back the other way, and Vasquez is now able to keep it in front. Cubs get a cheap run. Joe Kelly gets a visit from Carl Willis.
Count on Zobrist. Rizzo at second, a run in. Cubs are within two. Russell on deck. And the pitch. Robbie Scott charged with his first major league run. It's a sellout, 37-054. It's Fenway Park tonight. At least 2-1. Base hit center field. Rizzo around third. The throw is up the first base line. 5-4.
There's that clutch hit the Cubs have been looking for. Lead off walk and a couple of big two out knocks. First Zobrist or Rizzo, now Zobrist. He stays on that high fastball, shoots it right back through the middle of the diamond. Got to it in good shape with the throw way offline.
Cup fans making some noise as Russell takes ball one. And let's go Cubbies, and the Red Sox fans trying to drown them out. Russell in the air to right. Easy play. Betts. Cubs get two. It's a 5-4 game of the seventh.
with a 5.40 ERA. Good job by Mike Montgomery, holding the Red Sox at bay. And we got a ball game all of a sudden.
Yeah, if the bullpen can hold him here.
Fans really getting energized in the top half of the inning, and that's got the whole place lit up. Red Sox fans starting to make a little noise.
So Josh Cantor, the Red Sox keyboardist, is
not Norm Pressey.
Chicago area native, Northwestern alum. And always plays really cool tunes here at Fenway. Two and oh on Betts. Swing and a miss.
Not uncommon for Pedro to have better command of his slider than his fastball.
Commander Heath Hembry. Quick pitch. Fly ball shallow right center. It's Al Mora.
Every series they have played, except for one, they were swept by Pittsburgh at Wrigley a couple weeks back.
He went around.
They used to call Manny Ramirez Man Ram. Do they call Hanley Han Ram?
Good question.
Very talented player. He's had a nice career. At times in his career, people have questioned his commitment to the game.
He can hit. Career 294. Swing and a miss. Strike three.
Take home a game used or autographed item and help benefit Cubs charities. Cubs Authentics is the premier outlet for all MLB authenticated Cubs memorabilia. Cubs will donate net proceeds from the sale of Cubs Authentics items to Cubs charities. Visit Cubs.com/authentics today. Yeah, well, that used to be the debate, right? A few years back, who was the better shortstop, Tulowitzki or Ramirez? They were two best in the game.
Moreland takes ball one.
But time marches on. Tulowitzki still plays shortstop. He's dealt with a lot of injuries the last couple of years.
There's now a young crop that may be the best ever,
including the two in this series.
Yeah, that's a strike. One and one on Moreland. Pedro's having a little trouble seeing the signs from Contreras. 2-1.
Change up. Don't see that very often.
Ryan Dunsink, left-hander up. Starter Arrieta. 4 1/3, gave up 5 on 10 hits. Nice work by Mike Montgomery. Got 5 outs, no runs, 2 hits.
Jake threw 98 pitches in 4 1/3 innings tonight. We've seen his ERA climb to 4.66.
And stroke. Well, 1-2-3-7. It's a one-run game late from Fenway. Cubs have hit a couple. Pretty cool. Chris Bryant played in the Cape Cod League, had been to Fenway, but his first major league game here, first at bat. And over the Green Monster, Albert Almora Jr. with a blast as well. And Eddie Vedder in the house rooting on the Cubs. Hall of Famer now with Pearl Jam. He'll be rocking the paradise tomorrow night.
This is right-hander Heath Hembry now on for the Red Sox. No relation to Alan Hembry. Got an H and an extra E. He's pitched 10 times and he has a 1.46 ERA. Apply for an all-digital no-fee loan now at eclicklending.com. Eclick is located right here in Chicagoland and rated A+. By the Better Business Bureau, eClick Lending. Boom! Your mortgage just happened. Heath Hembry from Cowpens, South Carolina.
Lined and caught right at Hernandez. Bad break for Contreras. That was a bullet.
Yeah, yeah, one-run ball game. Thinking maybe double in the corner. Instead, it's one quick out. All you can do is smile, shake your head. And that was a bullet. With that reaction by Hernandez, didn't know whether to duck or try to catch it.
Tough night for Hayward against the lefty. Pomerantz, fly ball well hit to left and off the wall. And he's going to have to hold. Second single we've seen tonight off the Green Monster.
Yeah, and I think as a base runner, you really have to fight the temptation when you hit the ball over the left fielder's head. You're always thinking two bases, but you have to, you know, realize what you're up against here at Fenway with Wall out there. So go hard out of the box, hope to get two, but be willing to settle for a single.
So interesting here, Joe is going to pinch hit for Baez. It'll be John Jay. Carl Edwards Jr. up in the bullpen.
Yeah, I think Joe just feels like Jay's got a better chance of having a competitive at bat here against Hembry. Javi's been in this funk, and Hembry's got a real good slider.
And a base hit. First and second, tying run in scoring position with one out.
So obviously there's a chance, and you know, not a chance, when anytime you take Baez out of the lineup, you're weakening your club a little bit defensively, but I understand why Joe did it. And John Jay, a lifetime 280 plus pinch hitter, delivers yet again.
Fernando Abad in the Red Sox pen, and Miguel Montero announced to bat for Almora, and John Farrell will make a change. That was on the base hit by Jay. Pitching change in the eighth. We'll be back. Montero announced. John Farrell goes with Fernando Abad, and then Joe says, "I'm going to go with Matt Caesar."
Yeah, well, you know, the team's so good at closing people out in the ninth inning. Why not do everything you can here in the eighth? As Russell and Bryant pour over some scouting reports.
Yep,
Fernando Abad.
You can have those iPads in the dugout now.
Bob's a veteran. He's been around for a few years. Good change up. See a little bit of that out of him. Probably a little bit below average in terms of his velocity. Over the last 3 years, right-handed batters hitting 219 against him, left-handed batters 216, so he's been one of those guys capable of getting both left and right-handed hitters out.
Hayward at second, Jay at first. Caesar swings and misses.
Yeah, the ability to throw, if you can get away with a changeup in that location, then you've got a really good changeup. The intent was not to throw it where that one ended up.
Pedroia trying to keep Hayward close. Fastball outside. That's a big split between the fastball and the changeup. It's 15 miles an hour. There's Kimbrel getting loose here in the eighth. Fouled off. One and two.
Bob broke in with the Astros back in 2010. Spent 3 years there, went to the Nationals. Oakland for a couple of seasons. Last year split time between the Twins and then here with Boston.
Is that the green monster?
I think they call him Wally, don't they?
Wally.
Well, it might be Mrs. Wally.
Oh.
Sister Wally or something.
The 2-2 pitch. And he got him. Did it change up?
It was.
So his change up tonight means he have a couple of different ones. The first one he threw was 75 miles an hour. That one was in the mid 80s. Interesting.
Well, the 75 might have been a curveball. Sometimes it
backed up.
Yeah, it'll kind of fade a little bit.
Guessing that's what it was. See if Schwarber can get it done with two outs. And yeah, that one definitely a curveball, so that's the slow pitch. Waited back and missed it.
Hot gun here tonight with Joe Kelly getting 102 and Fernando Abad 95. That's
He's been 75 to 95 on his pitches here in the eighth. Fans on their feet. And as you see, a lot of Cubs blue here at Fenway tonight. 2-2.
Schwarber reaches. Farrell bringing Kimbrel, will he not?
No doubt. Yeah, if you're going to get your closer up in the eighth, and the bases end up loaded with Chris Bryant coming up, you probably have to. Sure, he'd rather Abad get Schwarber here. Runners will be moving with two outs. There they go. Here it comes. And that one, tomahawk foul down the right field line.
And that was an off speed pitch up in his eyes. His location has not been real clean here in this inning. He's gotten away with some stuff. You get a strike.
And he didn't, but he swung at it, and that's that. So Abad gets out of it, and the Red Sox still lead late.
Trying to keep the Red Sox right where they are. They've got a 5-4 lead. All their runs came in the first inning.
Yeah, six batters into the game. Five of the first six batters that batted scored. The Red Sox sent 10 to the plate in the bottom of the first. So they sprinted out to the lead, and they've been hanging on for dear life ever since. Matt Caesar is the new center fielder. Ben Zobrist slides over to second base. I guess more accurately moves into second base. John Jay is the left fielder.
From the wind and the pitch to Pedroia, fouled for a strike.
coming in the Cubs pen with the best ERA in the National League. Been really good as of late. Made the oil can Boyd reference to describing Carl Edwards Jr. 6'3", 170. Oil can 6'1", 155. Pitched mostly with the Red Sox.
Oil can was from Mississippi, I believe.
Yep.
So both sons of the South. The heater down and away, it looks like. A cutter.
Two.
Yeah, it gives you a tough AB. You see a lot of pitches, don't swing and miss very much.
Hit to right. Three reaches from the sixth spot.
Follow Cubs baseball live with the MLB.com at bat mobile app. Stay connected to the game's best players all season long with game day, live game video highlights, radio broadcast, stats, news, and more. Download MLB.com at bat today. It's your number one app for live baseball.
Bradley with a man on, nobody out. A pitch inside. Easy gas. Mid-90s cutting action from Carl Edwards Jr. Curve that time. One and two. Strike three. Well, that's a tough pitch to get called, but he got it.
You know, Mike Everett's zone tonight's been a little difficult to pin down. It seems to me in some of these called strikes been a little hesitation on his part. Just held it there, gave him a good long look at it. And it said, yeah, that's good enough.
Two hits and an RBI for the catcher Vasquez. The pitch, it's a strike. Have turned three double plays tonight. One was a line out double play. And two.
couple plays in the fourth, fifth, and sixth inning. Jelly-legged him with the curveball. Troy doesn't look to steal bases very much. Did when he was younger.
Swing and a miss. Or out number two.
That cutter up in the zone, threw it right by him. Troy early in his career, you can count on him for 20 steals a year. Did that on four different occasions, 20 or 20 plus. Since the beginning of the 2014 season, he has not been doing a whole lot of running. Last year, he stole seven bases, was caught four times. This year, 0 for 1.
Hernandez has had a nice night against his original organization. Two hits, nice defensive play. So Rob Contreras of a hit back in the eighth. Contreras kind of laughed when he looked down at Hernandez. I'm guessing they were teammates at some point in the Cubs minor league system. In fact, I would bet on
it. Yeah.
That's a strike. And the interesting thing is, JD, a year earlier than when Hernandez was traded, mm-hmm. December 14, if it had been December 13, the Cubs may have traded Contreras. Right? Because he was just kind of.
Yeah, just kind of a guy.
Floundering in the Cubs system. And then everything changed at Double A. And he struck him out. So Pedroia with a leadoff single. And then Edwards catches Bradley looking. And gets Vasquez. And Hernandez swinging to the ninth, 5-4. Around some traffic. Gave up a couple of home runs, but would be in line for the win tonight.
Yeah, he gave up the two solo home runs. There are other opportunities the Cubs had against him. They put him in a few crisis situations, and he was able to pitch out of it, punched out seven in six innings of work, allowed just the two runs.
Vinny's Beverage Depot is the official champagne provider of the Chicago Cubs.
So the challenge for the Cubs now is to get something done against Craig Kimbrel, who's converted 7 of 8 save opportunities. He has punched out 17 in 9 1/3. He's retired 18 of the last 19 batters he has faced, 12 of those by strikeout. Upper 90s heater and a lock you up curveball.
Yeah, to say Kimbrel got off to a historic start. His time with the Atlanta Braves, 5 years. Pretty breathtaking. And a first pitch strike on Bryant. Four-time All-Star with Atlanta. 294 appearances, a 1.43 ERA. Not quite that good the last couple of years, although he was an All-Star last year with Boston. 1-1. A one swing ball game. His first four full seasons of the majors, he led his league in saves. Two. Foul.
Didn't get it quite high enough. Right, put a good swing on it.
Eddie almost had a shot at that one.
Kimbrel came up with the Braves. Remember, is he and the lefty Johnny Venters? And Venters, his career was sidetracked due to injury, but I remember them both being there as young players at the same time, and I thought Venters' stuff was every bit as good as this guy. I mean, he had all kinds of movement.
Right on the swing, second consecutive at bat, he gets called out on the swing by the home plate umpire.
I didn't think he went last time, and I don't think he went this time either, at least not from that angle.
Batter is Rizzo. Feels a lot like Wednesday night. Comes down early. Came back, made it a one run game. Came up short 6-5 in Pittsburgh. Down 5-1 after one here tonight. Now within a run late. Ball almost hit him. One strike on Rizzo. Zobrist next. The pitch outside.
If you're wondering why Kimbrel does what he does at the start of his delivery, I can't give you a good reason for it other than he thinks it's cool. And it's okay. I mean, there's no pitching reason or mechanical reason why you would start like that. As far as I know.
Guess he used to have his arm behind his back, but he had some tendonitis and it started to hurt.
So he's ready to grapple.
He just said it's comfortable. Rizzo shortening up with two strikes.
Short and quick. Always a good game plan against a guy like Kimbrel who throws close to 100 miles an hour. Climb and they make it all the way back to even.
Two down. Kimbrel got that big deal, 4 years, $42 million from Atlanta, and then moved to the Padres as they were in go for it mode for about 10 minutes. And now he's with the Red Sox. The pitch is a strike on Zobrist. Hey, you know what? I say that in jest, but got to give the Padres credit, right, for at least eight. A.J. Preller realizing this is not working. Got in the sell mode very quickly. The pitch, swing and a miss.
Yeah, I think the worst thing to do is dig in and just not be willing to admit your mistakes and then pay for it even further down the road.
Hit hard and that'll get past Moreland. Zobrist on his way to second. He's in. Tying run in scoring position for Addison Russell.
Boy, Zobrist been good tonight all night long. Couple line outs, a walk, single, and now this double. And you've got a guy in Kimbrel who has one of the highest strikeout rates of any active pitcher, and Zobrist, a guy who rarely strikes out, so it was set up to be an intriguing battle, and Zobrist wins it. Gets it out in front of that one. Whacks it by Moreland. Scampers on into second base.
This place is electric.
I was going to say, Addy can handle that good gas.
Playoff atmosphere in late April. Drama in Boston. Here's the pitch. Low and outside. Talking about 1918 and joking the Cubs and Red Sox after that World Series said, yeah, this was fun. Let's do that again.
I'm sure we'll be back some point.
Yeah, 2003, it almost happened. And a lot of people think this year it could happen. 1-1.
It's 99, letter high from kind of a low three-quarter arm slot. Just slings it up there, riding fastball. To force him down a little bit.
Might be a time for a B-hack with two strikes. Swing and a miss. And the Red Sox take the opener. All three outs were strikeouts in the ninth. As the Red Sox win 5-4.
They got some power arms in that bullpen. We saw Joe Kelly at 102 miles an hour, and then Kimbrel comes in throwing darts. Cubs struck out 14 times tonight. They mounted a heck of a comeback, but up just a little bit short.
Well, John Lackey will get the ball tomorrow. Cubs are 4-3 on this road trip. It'll be a late afternoon start and a Sunday night game before the Cubs head home. And when we do head home, we'll be right back here on CSN. Pre-game coverage Monday night, 6:30. Phillies and the Cubs open a four-game series. Final score once again, the Red Sox 5, the Cubs 4. We'll have Blue Cross Blue Shield Cubs post-game live next.